Baker from Newcastle Speech Pathology, and I'm here today with another Communication Corner tip. All this month we've been looking at words to describe emotions and feelings. Today we're going to talk about times when our emotions can be more troublesome, such as when we're in conflict with our friends. For our little ones, they're going to need a lot of help learning how to navigate some more complex social issues, like learning how to share in the playground, learning how to deal with that frustration when they want to keep playing but it's time to pack up. So we're going to talk about some words and some ways of helping your little ones learn these new social situations. At Newcastle Speech Pathology, we like to use social stories to help with really common situations that little ones come up with where they frequently have trouble. So something we see a lot is little ones who are biting and hitting when they're feeling frustrated. So what we do is we help them learn about these emotions by talking about them when they're feeling calm. So when they're feeling calm, we can talk to them about that time when they were asked to pack up and they felt angry, they felt frustrated, and they wanted to hit something. And instead, we can tell them about some helpful ways to deal with those emotions. One way we do this is with social stories, like this one on our iPad here. All about my mouth and the things I can do with my mouth. And when I'm feeling frustrated, I'm not going to bite people. Social stories are usually written in the first person from the preschooler's perspective. We often work really closely with the preschool, getting photos of the little one, playing games, and in situations where these sorts of feelings arise. When teaching our little ones about emotion words, it's always good to have a conversation with them when they're feeling calm. It can also be helpful to think about and help them to think about how their friends and their other classmates are feeling as well. It's hard to stay angry with someone when you've taken the time to think about how they are feeling. You can click the link below to get these communication tips in your inbox each week.